Hello and welcome to this What's New to DBLab 212 video featuring the release of our SCN Nearfield add-on. The Nearfield add-on is closing a small gap in our R&D system product line between our two measurement robots, the SCN scanning vibrometer and the large NFS 3D Nearfield scanner. The SCN scanning vibrometer has been a long-standing product at Klippel that enables automated positioning of a triangulation laser in relation to a dot and automated voice call excursion and cone vibration measurements. The larger NFS enables acoustic holographic measurements of loudspeaker systems, as well as shown here with the NFS baffle of transducers. Due to its holographic measurement principle, can simulate free field conditions in normal rooms and does not require an anechoic room. The NFS is quite suited for loudspeaker systems, as well as for larger transducers with the NFS baffle, as shown here for an 18-inch subwoofer transducer. But for smaller transducers, the large NFS is quite an investment in space and hardware. That is why we're introducing the SCN Nearfield add-on. The Nearfield add-on is a hardware and software add-on package for the SCN robot that enables acoustic measurements and scanning. The add-on package comprises an acoustically transparent microphone sensor arm to mount a microphone to the Z-axis of the SCN robot and a small round baffle setup which is mounted to the turntable of the SCN robot, which enables mounting transducers and enforces acoustic hull space conditions. The Nearfield add-on enables directivity testing in half space on the SCN for transducers up to 300 mm or approximately 11 inch, and even for small loudspeaker systems which can be placed directly on the baffle and operated in a half space condition. Despite the small and round baffle, accurate free field data can be generated with the same holographic measurement principle used by the large Klippel NFS. Due to this measurement principle, there is also no need to place the SCN with the Nearfield add-on in an anechoic room. The holographic measurement principle is based on the measurement of multiple impulse responses directly in the near field. The impulse responses are measured on a double layer grid which envelops the full device under test. From these impulse responses, a field identification is performed, which provides a solution for the acoustic wave equation and a full description of the wave field around the device under test. During this field identification, two separate waves are identified. One wave which originates inside the measurement grid and describes the direct sound of the device under test. Another wave which originates outside of the measurement grid and describes external reflections like room reflections or reflections in the baffle itself. After this field identification, the wave component of the direct sound can be extrapolated into the far field and visualized with an extensive set of graphs and visualization features at any point in 3D half space. In addition to the separation of room reflections and the measurement in normal rooms, the direct sound separations also enables the use of the very small round baffle. The Nearfield add-on features a split baffle construction with a round outer baffle with an outside diameter of 450 mm and a rectangular insert in the baffle in which transducers are mounted up to a size of 300 mm. The full baffle is also supported by an aluminum backplate. Due to this construction, the baffle is far less prone to parasitic mechanical vibrations in comparison to traditional large size baffles used in anechoic rooms. With a side view at this baffle, the direct sound separation of the holographic measurement principle can be explained. The main sound component which should be measured is the direct sound of the device under test. The first parasitic sound component is the baffle edge diffraction due to the acoustic impedance jump from half space to full space. The second parasitic sound component is the acoustic shortcut due to the small baffle size. Further parasitic sound components are reflections of room boundaries like walls, ceiling, or furniture. When we now introduce the double layer measurement grid of the holographic measurement, we see that only the direct sound originates inside the measurement grid. Because of that, the direct sound separation can completely cancel out edge diffraction and acoustic shortcut. With the SCN Nearfield add-on, the room reflections are only attenuated, not fully cancelled. This is because during the measurement, the baffle is rotated on the turntable and the interaction between device and the test and the room does not stay constant. The Nearfield add-on still achieves high measurement precision and accurate free field results due to the Nearfield measurement in very close proximity to the device under test and the high signal-to-noise ratio to these attenuated room reflections. The holographic field identification is based on a wave expansion of spherical waves based on spherical harmonics. So during a field identification, each of these spherical harmonic shapes is weighed by a frequency-dependent coefficient. The amount of coefficients needed to accurately describe a sound source is greatly reduced when the sound field of the source features symmetric properties. For example, the sound field of a round transducer features a rotational symmetry over a wide frequency band. This rotational symmetry effectively reduces the number of coefficients during the field amplification to coefficients of spherical harmonics with the suborder m equals 0. This reduction of coefficients also reduces the amount of measurement samples needed in the near field, and therefore measurement time. An example of a measurement with a holographic expansion order of 30 shows this very clearly. Without any symmetry, 961 coefficients are needed for this measurement, which will lead to a measurement time of approximately 2 hours. By introducing a baffle and enforcing half-space symmetry, the coefficients are already cut in half, and so is the measurement time. When we go even further and assume a rotational symmetry in conjunction with this baffle symmetry, the number of coefficients can be reduced to only 16, which will lead to a very fast measurement time of approximately 5 minutes. The best way to fully understand the capability and features of the SCN Nearfield add-on is to look at measurement results. Here you can see a time-lapse of the SCN movement during a near-field scan of one of our R&D example transducers, which are cost-effective 4-inch automotive transducers. During each of the small stops, a sweep is performed and an impulse response is measured. The movement may seem a bit erratic at first, because the order of measurement points is sorted by a point-sorting algorithm in order to save measurement time. After the automated measurement, the results are processed and viewed in our DBLab software. In the DBLab software, first let's look at the results of the field identification. Here you can see the field identification is based on a little bit over 360 measurement points, which leads to a maximum holographic expansion order of 20. For lower frequencies, the holographic expansion order is limited to ensure numerical precision. The fitting error of the field identification describes the residual error between the identification results and the measurement samples. Here you can see this is a very good fit, and the fitting error is below minus 20 dB over the whole range of the driver. Only for very low frequencies, the fitting error is rising above this limit. This is because the driver has a very low sensitivity at this point and does not reproduce any low bass. So in this area, the fitting error is mainly limited by ambient noise and the signal-to-noise ratio during the measurement. Another interesting thing to look at is the near-field transfer function. In this case, this is the transfer function of an on-axis point directly 6 cm in front of the driver. Here we can see the measured transfer function and the fitted transfer function, which are almost identical because this is a very good fit. Also, we can see the radiated transfer function of the direct sound, which is separated from the fit due to the direct sound separation. Here we can clearly see the first interference of the baffle edge diffraction, which is separated out, and the acoustic shortcut, which is separated and leads to an increased bass response in the radiated transfer function. Because this field identification is done from a full scan and no symmetry was assumed during the generation of the measurement points and the field identification, the identification can also be used to check the symmetry of the sound field. In this case, we see the driver is very symmetrical, and when we look at the rotational symmetry, we see that over 90% of the sound power has a rotational symmetry up to a frequency of approximately 15 kHz. So for this driver, the measurement speed could be increased with a symmetry assumption. Now, let's look at the extrapolation of the direct sound of this measurement. Here we can see the numerous plotting and evaluation features of the NFS visualization. First, let's look at this transfer function. The transfer function can be extrapolated to any point in 3D half-space. In this case, it is extrapolated to an on-axis point 10 meters in front of the device in the test, and then referenced to the standard evaluation point of 1 meter with an excitation level of 2.83 volts, equal to a 1 watt excitation of this 8 ohm device. Because the holographic measurement provides a full description of the sound source, in addition to transfer functions, also the full sound power radiated by the device can be visualized, as well as a directivity index can be calculated. Another valuable plot is the contour plot, which plots the directivity of the device over the full frequency band and theta angle for a given phi angle. In this case, phi is 90 degrees, so it is a contour plot over the horizontal plane. The contour plot delivers a comprehensive picture of the device directivity and visualizes beaming at higher frequencies, enables the analysis of side lobes or other directivity inconsistencies, like in this case the on-axis dip between 1 and 2 kHz. For more detailed analysis at a single frequency, the polar plot can be used, which plots the directivity for a single frequency and phi angle over the theta angle. Also, the balloon plot can be used, which does the same, but for the full theta and phi angle. Here in the balloon plot, we can also clearly see the symmetric properties of the device. The balloon plot is currently plotted for a frequency of 8 kHz, where the device is starting to deviate from the rotational symmetry. Here we can see, up to an off-axis angle of approximately 60 degrees, the device is still very symmetric. Only in the last 30 degrees radiated close to the baffle, the device is starting to become asymmetric. Other visualization features enable the analysis of the impulse response and the group delay, which can again be extrapolated to any point in 3D half-space. Also, the beam width can be analyzed, which enables easy calculation of coverage angles. In addition to these typical far-field extrapolations, the holographic measurement provides also a valid description for the near field in close proximity to the device. So the sound pressure can be visualized for this area, which is very valuable for devices like headphones, small speakers, laptops, and other devices where the listener is directly located in the near field. Also, multiple transfer functions can be generated for the near field, like for this example, for a left and right ear setup, 1 meter in front of the device. To get a better understanding of the power of the holographic measurement and direct sound separation used to create these curves, let's look at the comparison to a far field measurement without this processing. Here, we see the comparison between the on-axis transfer function calculated by the holographic measurement and the comparison to a measurement with a microphone placed directly 1 meter in front of the device. Both measurements were done in an ordinary office room. As you can see, the traditional measurement with the microphone is highly corrupted by room reflections, room modes, baffle edge diffractions, and by the acoustic shortcut. Some windowing has been already applied to this curve to gate out some of the room responses. At higher frequencies, the window length could be shortened to get a clearer picture. At lower frequencies, this is not possible because this would lead to excessive smoothing of the curve due to zero padding. Especially at lower frequencies and in the mid-range, we can clearly see room modes which are disturbing the measurement, and we can see the drastic influence of the acoustic shortcut which corrupts the bass response. So all in all, this curve is not really useful to get a clear picture of what the driver is doing, whereas the holographic measurement is providing clean measurement results which can be interpreted. The accurate free-field results from a holographic measurement with the SCN near-field add-on can also be used in conjunction with other Clipper modules. For example, a fundamental and harmonic transfer function measurement for distortion analysis with our GIF transfer function module can be done in an ordinary office room and then compensated to provide free-field results with our in-situ room compensation and the reference curve provided by a holographic measurement with the SCN near-field add-on. First, let's look at such a harmonic measurement in an office room without the compensation. This measurement was done with an excitation level of 6 volt RMS to reach the driver's maximum excursion, so there is quite some distortion to be expected. The microphone was placed at the typical 1 meter on-axis evaluation point. Here you see the fundamental is again corrupted by the room response, and so are also the harmonic transfer functions. And we now look at the relative distortion, or at the THD in percent. Especially beneath 300 Hz, the measurement is highly corrupted and does not represent the actual distortion of the driver, but more or less the room. Even at higher frequencies, the distortion figure is noisy due to room reflections and reverberation, and the measurement is not reliable. With the harmonic measurement in the near field, a free field correction with our in-situ compensation, and an extrapolation to the 1 meter evaluation point, far more stable results can be achieved. In this case, the measurement is done at a distance of 25 cm from the device, and the correct free field response is calculated from a previous holographic measurement. This free field response is then used to calculate a correction curve and correct the measurement. After the correction, the measurement is then extrapolated to the 1 meter evaluation point. When we look at the results of this compensated measurement, we can clearly see that the fundamental response is smooth and clean, and the harmonic measurements also provide plausible results. When plotted as a relative distortion or THD, this measurement provides an accurate distortion figure of the measured driver. At low frequencies, the total harmonic distortion increases due to the high voice coil excursion and non-linearities of the motor structure and suspension. In the mid-frequency range between 1 and 2 kHz, there is also some distortion present, which occurs due to high local excursion of parts of the loudspeaker diaphragm due to a mechanical resonance and a prominent quadrature component, the vibration pattern. A comparison between the traditional measurement with the microphone at the 1 meter position and the compensated near field measurement clearly shows the effectiveness of this compensation method. At the top is the compensated near field measurement, and at the bottom is the corrupted traditional measurement due to the measurement in a normal office room. In addition to these free field corrected harmonic measurements, the near field add-on hardware can also be used together with the triangulation laser of the SCN robot and other clipper modules, like for example the LPM module, to determine linear small signal parameters, also known as Teeler small parameters, or our LSI module to determine nonlinear parameters. A direct comparison between the 3D near field scanner and the SCN with the near field add-on clearly shows the qualities and features of each unit. The 3D near field scanner is of course a larger unit and has more space requirements than the SCN near field add-on, which is much more compact. The near field scanner is suited for measurements of small up to large size loudspeakers, and with the NFS baffle, also for small to large size transducers. The SCN near field add-on is mainly suited for the measurement of transducers up to a medium size of 300 mm. Or approximately 11 inch. Small loudspeakers can also be measured on the SCN near field add-on in a half-space operating condition. They can be directly placed on the baffle and measured in this setup. These small loudspeakers have to fit in a hemisphere with a radius of 140 mm or approximately 5.5 inch. Due to the fixed baffle setup, the SCN near field add-on can only do half-space or 2π measurements, whereas the near field scanner can also do acoustic full-space or 4π measurements. On the NFS, the device in the test rests on the central pole. The direct sound separation can provide a full separation of all room reflections. Whereas on the near field add-on, the device in the test is rotated with the turntable, and the interaction with the room does not stay constant during the measurement. Therefore, the room reflections can only be attenuated, and the typical free field position of plus minus 0.5 to plus minus 1 dB is reached depending on the quality of the room. Due to the fixed baffle setup on the SCN near field add-on, the setup of a measurement is very simple and fast, and only a single setup point is required. The large near-field scanner provides much more flexibility and enables the setup of devices under test and baffles in various positions, but requires much more setup points and more setup time. Bluetooth and wireless devices can currently be measured on the near-field scanner with our asynchronous measurement, which compensates for variable delay during the measurement. Currently, this asynchronous measurement is not yet supported on the SCN near-field add-on, but a later update is planned to support also the measurement of Bluetooth devices on the near-field add-on. All in all, the SCN near-field add-on is a valuable addition to every Klippel SCN. It enables acoustic measurements and directivity testing with the SCN and requires no anechoic room. With the near-field add-on, the SCN becomes capable in testing in all loudspeaker-relevant domains and can test in the mechanical domain with the laser, the acoustical domain with the microphone of the add-on, and also in the magnetic domain when a Klippel BFS sensor is added. The near field add-on software as well as the hardware also has a high synergy with other Klippel modules. Distortion measurements can be done with free field correction with the in-situ compensation. The add-on is compatible with other modules like the LPM, the LSI or the TRF. And the near field add-on baffle also enables easy mounting of transducers with the back ventilation, also for mechanical cone vibration scans.